It's Tuesday, 20th August, and this is Top Stories by Rooster News. Neeraj Chopra let his throws do all the talking as he shattered his own national record on his way to the men's javelin gold at the Asian Games yesterday. Neeraj's friend, Taipei's Asian record holder Chao Tsun Chung, had said that it would take 88 meters to win this year, and that's exactly what the Indian did, though Chung was nowhere in the picture. The 20-year-old now becomes the country's first javelin thrower to strike gold at the Asiad. Just one effort, his first, at 83.46 meters, was enough to bring him the gold. And the big one, the 88.06 meters that broke his 3-month-old national mark of 87.43, came in the third round. India also won three more silver medals through 400-meter hurdler Dharun Ayyasamy, long jumper V. Nina, and steeplechaser Sudha Singh. In other sports, Anu Raghavan clocked a personal best of 56.92 to finish fourth in women's 400-meter hurdles, while high jumper B. Chetan was eighth with 2.20 meters. China appears poised to scrap the limit on the number of children couples can have, with a state-run newspaper yesterday citing a draft civil code that would end decades of controversial family planning policies. The wide-ranging code would get rid of a policy that has been enforced through fines but was also notorious for cases of forced abortions and sterilizations in the world's most populous country. A newspaper yesterday said that the code omits any reference to family planning, the current policy which limits couples to having no more than two children. The Communist Party began enforcing a one-child policy in 1979 to slow population growth. The limit was raised to two children in 2016, as the nation scrambled to rejuvenate its graying population of some 1.4 billion people. Concerns are mounting that an aging and shrinking workforce could slow down its economy, while gender imbalances could lead to social problems. Drones, their operators and pilots will have to be mandatorily registered on the aviation regulator DGCA's online portal effective December 1st. The use of remotely piloted aircraft, a kind of drone, is allowed for taking photographs, conducting surveys such as for the laying of pipelines and agricultural purposes and surveillance, as per the regulations on remotely piloted aircraft system unveiled by the Ministry of Civil Aviation yesterday. The rules bar the use of drone for the delivery of items. They can be deployed for spraying pesticides and delivering relief material during a natural disaster only on a case-by-case basis. Users will also have to go online to seek a unique identification number for each drone as well as an operator's permit license. They will have to provide details of the flight path to be undertaken for every flight. However, nano drones are exempt from all these prerequisites. Drones are barred from being flown near airports, international borders, coastlines, the parliament, secretariat complex in each of the state capitals, military installations, and eco-sensitive zones. In a short span of 1 week during July this year, 8 passengers died in 3 different train accidents at the St. Thomas Mount railway station in Chennai. An investigation carried out by the Commissioner of Railway Safety, K.A. Manoharan, into the deaths has exposed how railway engineers were ignorant of the design specifications prescribed under the Schedule of Dimension and allowed infringement of a concrete structure and steel pillars, thereby putting passengers travelling on footboards at grave risk. The CRS probe was ordered after 5 passengers travelling on the footboard of a crowded suburban train were killed when they collided with a concrete fence as the train approached the station on July 24th. He categorised the accident under the heads Error in Engineering Construction and Maintenance and Error in Passengers' Method of Travel. Mr. Manoharan, however, said that the incident was caused due to passengers hanging and leaning outside the coach, coming into contact with infringing concrete fence at St. Thomas Mount. We round up this newscast with fuel prices from key metros. In Delhi, petrol is sold for 77.96 rupees per litre, and diesel for 69.51 rupees per litre. In Chennai, petrol is sold for 80.99 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.43 rupees per litre. In Kolkata, petrol is sold for 80.89 rupees per litre and diesel for 72.35 rupees per litre. In Mumbai, petrol is sold for 85.38 rupees per litre and diesel for 73.79 rupees per litre.